I'm Tiffany Wong with news from here in Taiwan and around the world. The government is teaming up with religious leaders to fight fraud in Taiwan. The heads of 20 religious organizations have agreed to help educate their followers about the dangers of scams. Fraud is becoming increasingly rampant in Taiwan. The first half of the year saw scammers make off with nearly 163 million U.S. dollars. That puts them well on the way to surpassing the 275 million they stole in the whole of 2023. President Lai Ching-te has made beating rising fraud in Taiwan a priority, pledging to raise funding for the cause fivefold next year. Taiwan's biggest oyster farming town was hit badly by Typhoon Gaemi and is struggling to get back on its feet a month after the storm. I spoke with farmers in Jiayi County to learn more. Oyster farmer Chen Jinyin brings in the day's harvest. He's been out since 5 a.m. collecting oysters in the waters near the coastal town of Dongshi in Taiwan's southern Jiayi County, only for a measly catch. It's been a month since Typhoon Gaemi raged across Taiwan, causing nearly 5 million U.S. dollars in damage to the county's oyster industry. But for oyster farmers like Chen, that price is much more. Oysters take a year to cultivate, and Typhoon Gaemi hit in July, right in the middle of peak harvesting season. The loss has farmers concerned for their businesses and livelihoods as they approach September's Mid-Autumn Festival, a major holiday for oyster consumption. Chen says the rafts he grows oysters on should each yield up to 50 buckets of oysters. But since the typhoon, he's lucky if he's able to get 10. He estimates losses of over 2,000 buckets of oysters worth 110,000 U.S. dollars.
很多人真的是需要再贷款。
The effects of the typhoon are expected to be felt for months to come. This is the main oyster harbor in Taiwan where farmers bring in the day's catches from bamboo rafts like these far offshore. Now the ones behind me are empty, but they'll be repaired and restocked for next year's harvest. That's when farmers hope that their lot will be back to normal. It's a hope that the rest of the community in Dongshi carries too. Besides oyster farmers, many women in the community are involved as shuckers, and several storefronts along the wharf are dedicated to serving all sorts of dishes featuring the shellfish. From grilled oysters to oyster omelet and vermicelli. With typhoons frequent in the region, oyster farmers have come up with ways to minimize their losses. But with the damage from Typhoon Gaemi already done, all these oyster farmers can do now is pick up and start again in the next season, as they work to keep Dongshi's oyster economy running. Andy Xue and Tiffany Wong in Jiayi County for TaiwanPlus. An endangered Formosan black bear has died of heat exhaustion after being rescued from a trap in southeast Taiwan. Forestry workers took the bear to a hospital after it was found snared on an indigenous reserve in Taidong County. The incident was the first bear rescue in the area, indicating conservation efforts there are making progress. However, recent damage to the environment is forcing the Formosan black bear to wander further into populated areas. Officials are working with the nearby community to remove traps and monitor the animals. Taiwan's top breakdancer has made history at an international hip-hop festival in the Netherlands. His impressive performance comes just 2 weeks after competing at the Paris Olympics. Leslie Liao has more.
Did you feel the earth shake? This is Taiwan's Olympic breakdancer, Quake. Shortly after the Paris Games, the B-boy headed to the Netherlands to compete in the notorious IBE, a major international hip-hop dance festival. And while there, he made history, becoming the first ever Taiwanese breakdancer to advance to the breakdancing finals. Though he didn't win it all, losing to Venezuelan breaker Alvin, he still managed to outperform over 300 competitors to take second place. But Quake says the pressures of putting on a historic performance may have affected him in the finals.
心理素质的训练跟建立吧，就是我可能要相对的再更轻松一点，再更纯粹一点，像前几轮一样。
And that was something he was able to do with his team, which made it to the top 8 of the competition.
我们没有用很杀戮的方式来battle，我们是有点having fun，我就是来有点像是传递我今天跳舞的情感。Quake
says this latest performance is still a validation of his skills. He's claimed one of the top spots at one of the world's biggest breakdancing stages, proving that both he and Taiwan have what it takes to compete with the best. Ryan Wu and Leslie Liao for Taiwan Plus.
With the Paralympics around the corner, Taiwan's team is looking to make up for a disappointing return from the last games in Tokyo. The squad this year is a mix of newcomers and experienced campaigners. Our reporter Sandy Chi met some of the Paralympians getting ready for Paris.
Giving it all they've got and determined to thrive at the upcoming Paralympics in Paris this summer. Taiwan's para-athletes are ready to bring home glory. This year, a total of 13 athletes will be competing in 7 sports under the name Chinese Taipei. The team is more confident this year, after having been allowed access to facilities at the National Sports Training Center in southern Taiwan. It's the first time such resources have been dedicated to the Paralympic team.
派兵的选手给我感觉说，他们是充满信心，然后一定会比上次好，甚至比上上次好哦，就是可以拿奖牌的那个企图心都非常的强哦。At
the last Paralympics in Tokyo, Taiwan claimed just one medal, with Tian Xiaowen bringing home a bronze in table tennis. She's hoping to go further this time round.
不断的在提升心态上吧，然后跟搭档的沟通跟默契，还有一些就是在
In taekwondo, many eyes are on Xiao Xiangwen, who ranks 4th in the world in his division.
其实，在准备的过程中还蛮紧张的，但也蛮兴奋的，因为踩到这么大舞台，然后也会蛮用心去准备它。那因为现在也是备战的时间，那也会努力把自己的体能再提升上来，然后把技术更加成熟一点，让自己可以获得更好的成绩。
Paris will be Xiao's first Paralympics. But at the other end of the experience scale is powerlifter Ling Zihui. Now 42 years old, she's going for her 6th Paralympics. Lin won gold in her event in 2004 and 2008. For her, the games are about more than just glory for her country. They also contain a promise to herself and to the sport.
我人生的很多成就感跟荣耀都是在建立这个运动上面找到的。
From young to old, new Paralympians and veteran champions, Taiwan squad are ready to make their mark in Paris. Alex Chen and Sunny Chi for Taiwan Plus.
Thank you for watching What's Up Taiwan. You can visit the Taiwan Plus website or follow our social media for more stories from Taiwan and around the world. Finally, today, we leave you with these images from the annual International Patchwork Festival in Russia. I'm Tiffany Wong. Take care and see you next time.
For more stories from here in Honolulu, Hawaii, and around the world, make sure to visit us on social media.